Hello and welcome to this introduction to how to get started using the AD528 during speech audiometry. The device itself has a built-in speaker and a built-in microphone that we can use to monitor what is coming back from the booth if we use the device together with a booth in the setup. When we do speech audiometry, in particular if we do microphone speech audiometry, it is needed that we have a monitor headset like this one here, so that when we set our level of the speaker, we get a more accurate level because it's closer to the speaker. So the device can be used in speech audiometry together with the monitor headset or the speaker and built-in mic. When you get the device, it is ready for you to get started, and the material is present either as WAV files or as an external input that you can put in, or using a microphone for doing your speech audiometry. If you are in a country where speech material is present as WAV files, they will be present on the device so that you are ready to get started when you get the device. On the device, you can change between these modes, also WAV file, microphone, and an external input to ensure that you may have some material recorded and some that may not be. You do so by long pressing on the speech test, and two bars will then appear for channel 1 and channel 2 respectively. You can change from WAV to an AUX, an AUX2 on the other channel, or the microphone underneath there. If you use a microphone or an AUX the first time you get started using your device, you need to calibrate the level of the output. That is done by long pressing again here on speech while you are in the mic or the AUX in it, together with the shift key, and you then have an overview of the channels and calibrate in accordance with the level so that you have an accurate level of the output that you send to the patient. That is something you need to do the first time you set up the device with the mic and the monitor headset that you use. I'll now show how to get started when all of this is set up and how you are now ready to use your speech audiometry. The example I will show, that will be by the use of the WAV files to get you through some of the functionality that has. Because when the material is built into the device, there are more things that we can do with the material while we do the speech audiometry. Up here we have the 5 function keys, where we have the start key. So we can press start, which will take us into the running mode. So our speech test is now running, and the patient will hear the sound being present. We can see the words that is currently being present to the patient, hear them on the speaker or on the monitor headset. Right now the monitor headset is connected, so I can hear the tones and the speech being presented through the monitor headset and see if that is correct or incorrect in it. I can then use the correct incorrect key to store the results correct or incorrect, or I can set up the device to run it automatically, which is what it's doing now. So after a set period of time, for this matter 2 seconds, it will store it as correct and jump on to the next word. That is what we do during the test and to collect our results. What we may want to do then when the result is finalized is to store the results, which is done up here. In case something was obtained incorrectly or there's something we need to edit for the score, we have put in the opportunity to edit the score here so that you can change the score in case you press correct or incorrect in the wrong way. So that is available as the first function key that we have. In addition to that, you can change your measurement type. Right now it's set for the SRT, the speech recognition threshold. That can be changed to the word recognition, where we have a word recognition 1, 2, and 3. The reason we have 3 different ones is that when you have set the word recognition 1, that is linked to a certain type of material, in this matter words, that is then linked to the list that goes with that particular material. So when you change from SRT to VR1 to VR2, it automatically changes the type and the list of material accordingly. The condition key can be used when you are in free field for setting the aided condition. You can use it binaural so that you present on both ears, or you can do it where it is both aided and binaural. They are the function keys that we have on the device. In addition to that, there are a few functions that I want to point out that can be beneficial to use during speech audiometry to get you through easier. Right now we have the table mode activated, so we see everything in a table. So when I press store, it appears in the table here. Instead of that, we can also go into our speech setting and say, I would prefer to see that in graph mode. We then have all of our speech material presented in a graph mode. That is a bit dependent on which user you are, whether you prefer a table or graph mode, but it can be changed as you wish to present it. An additional feature I want to point out that can be a benefit to you is if you're in a country where you may use English as the main language, but have an additional language that you want to use, could be Spanish, for instance. You can then press Shift Lists, and if you then have a Spanish material on the device also, that will appear for you to choose directly from the main screen. In case you are more interested in knowing more about how to perform speech audiometry, we have some quick guide provided on Interacoustics homepage that takes you through step by step on how to use and do speech audiometry. Thank you for listening to this introduction, and I hope you got something out of the overall introduction of speech audiometry on the AD528.